Again, welcome to those in the sanctuary and those online. It's good to be here again and good to see everybody. And I would like to take a moment, if we have any guests with us here in the sanctuary, if you don't mind raising your hands, if you're here for the first or second time. Here we go. All right. It's good to have you. Happy Sabbath. And if you don't mind, would you mind telling us your name or probably where you're visiting from? Okay, Ken and Billy from the Madison Church, welcome. Amen. Glad you could join us this morning. And
Carolyn Griffiths from the Madison Church.
Okay.
Amen.
So Johnny and Karen from the Carolyn. Sorry, thank you. Oh, how nice! It's a pleasure to have you this morning. And I would like to just take a second to just welcome our guests and just say hi to your fellow neighbors. So. At this time, I would like to go over the announcements. We have a few that we like to get through. And first up is a second reading transfer in for our sister Jennifer Namehard from the Lawrenceville SDA Church, Lawrenceville. And so being a second reading, we'll have a vote. And I already see Elder Rick for the first motion. Do we have a second? And a whole heap of second hands, and awesome. So if you guys don't know, I'm gonna put her on the spot, Sister Jennifer. Sister Jennifer, do you mind stand so that others who don't know you may be able to say hi, amen. Amen. All right, that was an easy one. And then next up, so next Sabbath, yes, Elder Rick. Oh, we didn't vote? Oh, I said, okay, all right, we have to make it official. So all in favor? All right, so it's carried. All right, so we can't, no excuses, right? And if anybody online objects, sorry, we can't see you. Oh, that's too funny. So next Sabbath, we know what's happening next Sabbath? We're gonna have a church camp, but that's correct. We're still having church here. But for those who are camping, you know, so they'll be there Friday, Saturday, and then they'll check out Sunday. But for those who are unable to come for the morning program, which I'm not sure what exactly is planned as yet, but Elder Rick will be here and he'll be worship leader and he'll be preaching, while Pastor and some of the others will be at the camp out. Some of us will probably go to the camp out afterwards, so you could, if you want, leave here, and then they will have potluck Sabbath lunch. So you could come here if you can make it up there in time, and then you could join them for lunch on Sabbath. Yes, Elder Rick. Oh yes, Fort Yargo. Oh, it doesn't say that yet, but it's on the next bulletin. On the next bullet, we'll see that. There's a little bit of suspense there. So part of that is the AY team will be having their AY program at Fort Yargo, and it's going to be at 3 p.m. Oh, yeah, it does say that there, right? Fort Yargo Campout. And that's being led out by Ayana and Laurie. So Laurie's number is there. If you want more information, you can contact her, or you could go talk to Ayana afterwards. For directions, it's pretty easy to get to. You could look it up. It's off 81. So it's a nice state park if you've never been. Nice trails. So looking forward to that. All right. So the next item on our announcement is the the Pathfinder Bible Experience. So this year, I'll just paraphrase it. So this year is the first year that we've taken some Pathfinders and entered the PBE competition. And if you've seen Ayan and the Pathfinders come up, they have to memorize different books of the Bible, and they go to different sessions, and they compete. They competed at the local level, then they competed at the conference level, then the union level. And they've made it all the way now. They were the first for the Southern Union, and now they're going to Colorado to compete in the finals. And this is the NAD PBE finals, which is going to be in Colorado the 19th to the 20th. So continue to pray for them. And if you're impressed with all the work they're doing, they're asking if you want to, you could make a donations in your tithe envelope. You just mark it PBE. And most importantly, continue to pray for them, for their competition and also for Journeying Mercies. Amen. Our next item is communion. That is today. We'll be having our foot washing and our communion service today. And you know, we'd love for everyone to take part. If you don't want to take part, you could always observe, but it's free for those who want to take part in the Lord's Supper. Let's see. Okay, here we go with the camp out. So again, this will be at Fort Yargo. And it will be from April 12th, so pretty much next weekend, from the Friday. They check in at Friday, and you will check out Sunday morning. Typically, checkout is probably 11 or 12 in the morning. The church has reserved a few campsites, so if you're interested in camping, you can talk to Miss Lucinda Cox to see if there are any slots available. And if you're planning to come, we'd appreciate if it's going to be like potluck style again, so you could donate food. There's a sign-up sheet in the foyer for, you know, if you can volunteer to bring stuff and for us to know your attendance. And that sheet is on the greeters table in the foyer there. Again, Lucinda's name is on the slide there, so if you need to contact her, you can reach out to her by her cell phone number there, or you could talk to her after church. And for your Sabbath school quarterlies, those should be in your mailbox. If you do not have a mailbox and you're a member, you can see Sister Carolyn Roberts, and she should be able to get you sorted out. And I think that's it. Is there any other announcements? All right, no more announcements. Okay, let us pray to seek the Lord for our service. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you, Lord, for this wonderful Sabbath day. We thank you for allowing us to come together in your presence and for being with each other so that we can worship you the way you ought to be worshiped, Lord. Be with us here and those online and those who are on their way. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. And we'll have Songs of Praise by Sister Tricia.
Happy Sabbath, Church. Redeem, his child and forever. Our next song is going to be "What a Wonderful Savior Is Jesus, My Lord." So many of us can testify today that God has been really good to us, and I want us to sing this song as if we mean it, like Jesus has been so good to us. We're here today, and so many are not able to come because of some kind of ailment or sickness and other issues that may arise this morning. We just want to sing and give praise and honor to God because he allowed us to be here today. Thank you. We're going to stand for our opening hymn. Marvelous grace of our loving Lord, grace that exceeds our sin and our guilt. This is another beautiful song, and we're going to sing all verses. Yonder on Calvary's Mount. Happy Sabbath.
Amen. Those were some wonderful words. Amen. Very beautiful. And you guys sounded really good too, so that was good. Okay, at this time, I would like to turn our attention to the prayer corner. And let us keep the following folks in our prayers as we pray this week. Demeter's father, who had surgery to remove his gallbladder. And thank the Lord, there was no complications, but they did find a malignant growth on the head of his pancreas. So let's continue to pray for healing. And as Demeter has asked, more importantly, that he'll come to know the Lord. So let us continue to pray for that. And then let's also remember Sister Althea's boss, Danielle, who is in the hospital and not doing well. Sister Althea, any update on Danielle? Okay. And then Billy Frentress, who had an EEG study done some time ago, and it went well, so now we're waiting on the results. So let's continue to remember Billy in your prayers. Georgia Foster's mom, she's still in the nursing home. She now has a trachea, and there she's seeing a speech therapist. So let's, hey Gigi, so let's continue to pray for her. And then Mary Douglas, let's pray for her as she travels. I'm not sure if she's away already or she's back, but she had her brother-in-law that passed away in London. And, you know, so pray for her and the family as she travels there. And let's see, who else do we have? Yes, I was waiting for them to move the slides. Okay. Yeah, see you now. Thank you. I believe they're back. I'm not sure, but let's continue to pray for them with the loss of their cousin. Let's pray for the family. They had to travel to Jamaica to make some arrangements. That person was a big impact for their lives. For anybody who have family overseas and you still have things overseas, you know, you rely on people. So that was that person. So it's a big impact to them. So let's continue to pray for them. And then we have health concerns, and we have a long list of folks. So I would just like to point out, if you notice, we did not call Mitzi's name. Mitzi is now supposed to be on this list. So to me, that's a graduation. So that shows you how the Lord has been working. And so we praise God for that. When I saw that this morning, I'm like, thank you, Lord. So let's continue to pray because he continues to do wonderful and miraculous things. And then at this time, let us kneel as we seek the Lord in prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, Lord, we come to you again, giving you thanks and praise for things that you've done for us that we're not worthy to receive, Lord. Lord, as we looked over the prayer corner, we just marvel at your works. And Lord, we can continue to be impressed that not only You do these things for us, but you speak them and it happens, Lord. So, Lord, we continue to have faith in you because you continue to remind us of your grace and your mercies that we clearly do not deserve. Lord, we want to continue to lift up those on the prayer corner, whatever they're going through. You know, Lord, the beginning to the end, we ask that you will be with them. They're traveling, or they're having health issues or a death, Lord. We just ask you would be with those families, Lord. Lord, we also ask that you will hear our personal prayer requests that we might have on our hearts this morning. For somebody that's here, there's something, they're just happy to be in your presence. There's something bothering them. And Lord, you have brought them to the right place. We pray that you will hear and answer those prayers in your will, Lord. We want to take a moment, Lord, to pray for those around the world that have heard of earthquakes here in the States and in Taiwan. Be with those families as well, Lord. I know you have your children that are affected. We pray that you will bring peace and comfort and safety for those who are affected, Lord. Lord, today is a special day for us as we'll have communion and foot washing. This is a ceremonial thing that we do not take for granted. It's another reminder that if it was just one of us here, you would still have done it over and over again. And for that, we are so thankful that we could participate in this, Lord. So, Lord, as we look forward to the foot washing and the communion, we ask that you will help us to bring our hearts and our minds to that place where we can be just merely worthy to accept that, Lord. Lord, we thank you and we look forward to your coming. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Okay, so now we'll have offering, and we'll have Tammy.
Good morning, church. Happy Sabbath. It's a beautiful day, isn't it? I'm going to read this story to you by Heather Thompson Day. This is her testimony. Years ago, a mentor of mine encouraged me to take my relationship with God as seriously as I take my career. She saw me as a very driven person, but she instructed me to make sure I connected with God at the beginning of each day. That began my habit of waking up before the sun rises around 5 a.m. to spend quiet time reading God's word and reflecting on it through prayer. A little bit ago, my husband and I noticed our daughter taking her Bible in the morning before getting ready for school. She found a corner in our living room to pray. When my husband asked her why she was up so early, she said, "Mommy gets up early to speak to Jesus, and I want to be like Mommy." I was so struck by my daughter. It was and is my desire that my daughter develops a deep personal connection with Jesus. I simply wasn't aware of just how much my silent witness of waking up early impressed on her. Whether this is your first time at church or your family has built this church, if you look around, it's likely that you will see someone whose spiritual journey with God you can learn from. Today's offering goes toward our church budget. In order for our church ministries to keep functioning, we depend on the generosity of members returning and visiting. offering to support our local church. Please bow your heads for prayer. Dear Heavenly and most gracious Father, we are so grateful that you have brought us here on this beautiful Sabbath day. We're so grateful that the sun is out today. Please help us to reflect on your goodness and your mercy to us today. Please help us to find moments and minutes to reflect on you each day. Help us to make a routine to connect with you every morning to help us build a stronger connection with you. Thank you for all you've done for us. We pray that you will bless and protect our families. We pray that you will bless the money that is going to support and further the church. In Jesus' name, amen.
Okay, so now we'll have children's story, and children's story will be brought to us by Sister Jennifer Siemens, And children, how we're doing it now, you'll come up and get your baskets, and then you'll go back out, and the adults will, you know, hold up their money, whatever they want to give you as an offering. So come and get your baskets.
Good morning, boys and girls. So I'm going to tell you guys a story about a kitten. Who here likes cats? I love cats. I've always loved cats, especially kittens. So this story happened about 10 years ago. My husband calls me from work and he says, "There's a bunch of newborn kittens here that are living under a dumpster." And I'm like, "Okay, and?" "Well, they need a home." "Okay, and?" "Well, can we bring one home? Can I bring one home?" "Absolutely not. We already have two cats and a dog. We are at max capacity. We cannot have any more animals." "But please," he basically turned into like an 8-year-old boy begging his mother for a cat. He begs, I give in, he brings the kitten home. We fall in love with this kitten. It's so small, it can fit into both of my little hands. We take it outside. My boys run after it. It's so, so tiny. It was probably only maybe a month old. So it was about 2 days later. We are getting used to this kitten. She's getting used to us. And it was getting late in the evening, and somebody left the back door open. And the kitten bolted outside. And I saw it run out, so I ran to get my shoes on to go chase it, and when I got outside, it was gone. I looked in the bushes, I looked in trees, I called the family out, "We have to find this kitten, she's gone." So we all look and look and look. And it gets darker and darker and darker. And eventually, we had to stop looking. And everybody kind of went to bed, and I stayed up, and I thought, I need to do something more than just look for this kitten. I need to do something bigger. What do you think I did? That's right, I prayed. But before I prayed, I must confess, I had some reservations, because I thought, maybe this is too small for God. Maybe he doesn't care about a little kitten. There's people starving in the world. There's kids that don't have homes. Does he care about a little kitten? Of course he does. So I got on my knees and I prayed for this kitten to be safe, and if it's God's will, for her to come home. And I went to bed, and the next morning we got up and I went out and I called, "Kitty, kitty, 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 kitty." She didn't come. Okay, that's all right. So I go inside and I do some daily chores and I go back outside. Let me call again. "Kitty, kitty, kitty." At this time, she still didn't have a name. We just called her Kitty. And I turn around to go inside and I hear, meow.
and I turned around, and here she comes. She came running back home to me. Now, I have a picture of her that I want to show you guys that I sent to the AV. AV, this is your cue. And this is a picture of my kitten, actually. Are you awake back there? I took this picture the morning that I found her. I know, isn't she so cute? I know, I love it. This was the morning that I found her, I thought, and actually 10 years ago when this happened, I thought this would be a really cool children's story one day. And then this next picture is her this past week. She is going to be 10 years old this year. She lives in that basket. And I can guarantee you that right now, at home, she is in that basket. She never leaves that basket, and if you take her out, she will run back and get in that basket again. But I just want to remind you guys that no prayer is too small or too big for God. He's always listening, and he's going to answer it in his time and in his way. We just have to have faith, and we have to trust, and we have to do our part, and we have to pray. Always, always pray. Who would like to pray now? Anybody? Oh, come on. You want to come over here? Come on. What's your name? Parker's going to pray for us.
Thank you, Lord, for everything you have done for us, food and every animal. And thank you for the bed you made for us, the light you made for us, and whoever doesn't have it, just make somebody have it. And thank you, Lord, for you all done. Amen. Amen.
You guys can go back to your seats.
So one quick question. Did you ever give that kitten a name?
Oh, yes. That's kind of funny. Her name is Tiss.
Tiss. Her name is Tiss. All right. Very nice story. Now we have scripture and prayer brought to us by Harper. Come on up.
Good morning and happy Sabbath. Our scripture reading today is found in the book of Hebrews, chapter 12, verse 2. Fixing our eyes on Jesus, the pioneer and perfecter of faith, for the joy set before him, he endured the cross, scorning its shame, and sat down at the right hand of the throne of God. Amen. Please bow your heads for prayer. Dear Jesus, thank you for this beautiful Sabbath day. Thank you for your sacrifice. Thank you for loving us and taking care of us. Please be with us today as we worship you together. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Harper. Beautiful. Now we'll have special music brought to us by Caitlin.
Good morning, happy Sabbath. Thank you for the special music. It was sweet. And thank you for the children's story. I'm glad you found your cat. They tend to run away, right? Yeah. And no matter how friendly you are, when they see you in the street, they pretend that they don't know you. It's like they make a treaty. You know, you are going to adopt me, it's okay. But don't think that you are going to be touching me whenever you want to. And if you see me in the street and I don't want to talk to you, don't insist. Because it's not going to happen. And if you become homeless, I'm gone. I'm not like those dogs that are going to stick around no matter what. I don't do those type of things. That is what cats do. Good morning, happy Sabbath. Today is a special day because it's Sabbath. Amen. And we are also having communion.
Amen.
And communion is one of those rituals that we celebrate. And it's a tradition, but it's a Bible tradition. And was commanded by Jesus himself.
Amen.
And there is a reason. It's a reason to connect with each other. And a reason to connect with God.
Amen.
And that promise. Sometimes when communion day comes, we have some taboos. And we say, we come with the ideas, am I saint enough to be part of communion? The reality is that we do it because we want to be saint enough. We want to be connected with God. It's not because we are perfect, it's because we need perfection. And every opportunity that we have to connect with God and with our brothers and sisters bring us closer to the plan that God has to with our lives. The first thing, according to our ceremonies that we have, is the foot washing ceremony. For those who are visiting that don't know what we do, during that time, we are going to divide in groups, like families are going to be in one room, and today we are going to ask the family to go ahead, and then the ladies, and then the man, and we have different rooms for the different groups. And then when I wash the feet with my wife and my children, I'm telling them, you know, I'm here to serve you. You know what I'm trying to say? When you do it with your brother, when you do it with your sister, when you do it among when we do it among ourselves, we are just telling people we want to be like Jesus. Do you remember that story of Jesus washing the feet of his disciples? Do you know that the disciples did not understand that? Why are you going to do that? In a world where everybody was trying to be the biggest one, the one in charge, and you are supposed to be the master, and now you are washing our feet? Not too long before that, a group of them were walking behind Jesus and discussing among themselves who is going to be the highest, the most important one in the kingdom of heaven. Because they were trying to be important. They were always watching for that. And Jesus had to tell them that in the kingdom of heaven, things are different. We are not here to lord over somebody else. We are here to love and to serve each other as God has done with us.
Amen.
So in the back, we have water. And you are going. I want you to participate. Don't keep yourself. It's sounding ugly. Don't keep yourself from doing it. Because it's an opportunity to get closer to your God. But do it with prayer as you do it. If you have something, if as you are leaving home, your spouse maybe did not speak in the way you expected, and you got a disagreement, just pray together. Ask for forgiveness. Hug each other. Tell them, you know, sometimes I go far, but I'm sorry. And just wash your feet together and ask the presence of the Lord to come into your life, your relationship, your family. Let's pray, and then we are going to start because of, at some point we are planning to have a bigger building, but we're still small. We are going to exit. We are going to ask the family after I pray to go first, and then once they are in the room, then I'm going to ask the ladies that came along or are single to follow, to be in the place where they are going to wash their feet. And then gentlemen are going to be the last group. Do you get it? Let's pray. Father, thank you for being here with us. Just be with us, touch us. We want to be different. We want to be like you. In your name, Jesus, we pray. Amen. Amen. Let's go families first. The primary room is where the families go, right? Go there. And then after I see the families, then the ladies are going to follow. Go families. I think they have prepared things to make it better today. So somebody let me know when people are in the room so I can send the ladies. And then the ladies go now, those that, if you have come by yourself or. And then the men.
Okay, while the men leave, we'll go ahead and start singing. We will sing Redeemed, hymn number 337. I'll ask you to join me. I don't think we'll have words, but you can use the hymn books in front of you and we'll sing. Redeem by the blood of the Lamb. wonderful, beautiful. I hear everyone singing. Our next hymn that we'll sing is Jesus Paid It All, 184, Jesus Paid It All. Hymn 184. Jesus paid it all to him I owe. Sin has left a crimson stain. He washed it white as snow. Song said it all, how we feel today. Jesus paid it all. Does anyone have a favorite? Anyone have a request that we could sing? I'll wait a few minutes. Redeemed. I think we just sang that. Unless we want to sing, is it two versions? Let's sing the other one. So we sang 337 and we'll sing 336. Ayanna, let me know if that's okay. Okay. Oh, 338. Okay.
Redeem, how I love to proclaim it. Redeem by the blood of the Lamb. Redeem through his infinite mercy, his child and forever I am. Redeem,
my blessed Redeemer. I think of my blessed Redeemer. I think of him all the day long. I sing for I cannot be silent. His love is a theme of my song. Come Thou Font. I'll share a secret. It's my favorite hymn. I'm sure it's a lot of people's favorite hymn. Beautiful hymn. Come Thou Font of every blessing, tune my heart to sing Thy grace.
Mercy never ceasing, call for songs of loudest praise. Teach me ever to adore thee. May I still thy goodness prove, while the hope of endless glory fills my heart with joy and love. I raise my Ebenezer, hither by thy help have come, and I hope by thy good pleasure safely to arrive at home. Jesus sought me when a stranger, wandering from the fold of God. He to rescue me from danger interposed his precious blood. Oh, to grace how great a debtor, daily and kind strength to be. Let thy goodness like a fetter by me closer still to thee. Brought to mind, O Lord, I feel it. Brought to leave the God I love. Here's my heart, O take and seal it. Seal it for thy courts above.
Amen. Amen. Oh, we'll see. Let's see. You sure? Okay, and after that, we'll sing hymn number 530.
Standing on the promises of Christ my King, through eternal ages let his praises ring. Glory in the highest I will shout and sing, standing on the promises of God. Promises of God's promises of Christ the Lord, bound to him eternally by love's strong cord. Beautiful. Let's do number 476. Burdens are lifted at Calvary. Can we get the words on the screen? AV. 476. Did I say 476? Let's go, 476.
Let us try number 422. We are marching to Zion. Amen. 108, Amazing Grace, how sweet the sound. Saves a wretch like me. Grace my God for amazing grace.
Thank you for coming back. In the book of Hebrews, chapter 12, verses 2 and 3, the Bible says, fixing our eyes on Jesus, the pioneer and perfecter of faith. For the joy set before him, he endured the cross, scorning its shame, and sat down at the right hand of the throne of God. Consider him who endured such opposition from sinners, so that you will not grow weary and lose heart. I want you to just picture it with me. I have a very vivid imagination since I was a child, which get me in trouble a lot of time. But that can be used for good as well. I imagine Jesus, he is in heaven. He doesn't need anything from human. God does not need anything from us. Amen. He is God. Amen. He's the king of the universe. Yes. But he is also love. Yes. He cares about you. Yes. You are important to him. Yes. You are so important to him that if you were the only sinner, you were the only sinner on earth, Jesus would have come just to die for you. Amen. You are so important to God that all the gold and the riches of this world are not enough to buy the price of your soul before God. That is how much he cares about you. It's not because you add anything to him, because he is God. Oh, come on. And he's going to be God no matter what, because he is God. That is unchangeable. But he loves you. He cares about you. And then imagine Jesus deciding to become a human and come and be born in a place where people were going to hate him just for doing the right thing. And then he knew before he was born that he was going to be put to shame, that he's going to be mistreated, insulted. He was going to go through hunger and he was going to be tired and weary physically. But anyway, he decided that one is going to be singing here soon. So don't worry about that. But then he decided to come and die because he saw something. He saw you. Come on. He see, you know, I see them now. If I don't die for them, their only future is eternal condemnation. If I die for them in the future, if they accept my sacrifice, they are going to be perfectly happy.
Amen.
They are going to be healthy,
yes.
No crying, no pain, no suffering, no tears, no death, no separation. He saw us in the future.
Amen.
Come on.
Amen.
And the Bible said that he scorned the shame. It's like he underestimated what he was going to go through because he saw you there.
Yes.
I was around 10 when I was getting ready to preach my first sermon. And I was reading in the book Desires of Ages, the chapter Gethsemane. And how Jesus went through all that anguish. Because it was not just being physically beaten. He was spiritually down. No, because he sinned.
Yes.
It's because he was carrying our sin.
Yes.
He was paying for our sin.
Yes.
He was suffering the anguish that sin brings to humanity.
Yes.
The whole world was weighing on his soul.
Yes.
And he was there crying and praying and asking God, Father, is there another way?
Yes.
And I remember as I was reading that chapter, as a child, I cried.
Yes.
Through the entire process of preparing that little sermon.
Yes.
And I remember saying that day, one of those days, I need to be a promoter of that cross.
Amen.
I need to talk about that Jesus.
Yes.
I want to be a pastor. Was a journey after that, because it was not my father's idea of me and the future either. But that Jesus that saw me there, and he did not care to go through suffering just because the joy of seeing me happy in the future, man, that got me. He sat with his disciples that night, trying to have dinner. They were celebrating Passover, the people of Israel, the Jewish people. And Jesus was part of those people. And it was supposed to be a feast. When we sit with people that we love and we are having good conversation and the food is good, we love it, don't you?
Yes.
The other day, one of my kids asked me, Daddy, what is the time that you enjoy the most in your life usually, that you usually have memory? And I'm a homeboy. If I'm not working, I'll be with the family. And after I went around in my mind, I said, the time when I sit at the table with the family,
amen.
When we eat, when we talk, the kids joke around and we laugh and we share and we taste and we feel good as we eat something that you like. And then you look at the people that you love in front of you. You know what I'm trying to say? And sometimes we have places at the table. The kids choose where I sit usually. I said that I'm not in charge anywhere. They said, no, daddy sits here between you and me, and they decide that. But but the people around me are people that I love. And I have said that I love to eat. So the combination of all of that makes a happy time for me. Jesus was eating and celebrating, but for him, was different. Because while the whole nation was celebrating a tradition, he was celebrating his death.
Yes.
Come on. He knew what was going to happen to him hours after that dinner. He knew that that dinner was going to be his last. But was not just a regular go to sleep and we are done. He had to go through so much after that. And he also knew that the people that were sitting around him, he loved them, but it's like they were not ready for anything. One of them was there,
yes,
with a clean face,
yes,
but he already finished,
yes,
a deal,
yes,
trying to give him to his enemies. And he was there sitting with those people,
yes,
eating with them.
Yes.
Can you imagine that? Can you imagine that evening?
No.
Was dark, no electricity. Some candles with the smell of some type of oil was in the room. The lightning was not that good. They were there, and outside was dark, very dark. But the sadness in the heart of Jesus was so heavy that you could touch it. That dinner, that day. For others, was a day of celebration. For my Lord, I'm going to ask the deaconesses to open the table for me as I keep explaining. In that table, we have bread with no yeast. The Bible, the yeast symbolizes sin and pride. And the bread symbolizes the body of Christ. Without sin, without pride, giving everything for those he loved, for humanity, for us. And the wine is grape juice that symbolizes the blood of the Lamb. There are religions that they believed in that the bread and the wine becomes part of your own body. Is not the Bible thing. It's just bread, it's just wine, it's just food. It's a symbol. And the symbol tells you that one day your Jesus came,
yes,
to die for you.
Yes.
But also tells you more. It's telling you that in the future, when at last we are going to be free,
yes,
free from suffering, from sin, from death, from anything that is now keeping us down, one day we are going to be sitting around a large table, a very long one.
Amen.
And we are going to be participating with him.
Amen.
We are going to pray. My friend and elder, Neil, is going to be asking for a blessing for the bread, and my friend Jean is going to be asking for a blessing for the wine. Now, after we do that, I'm going to instruct the congregation to stand up, and then as you receive your part, you sit down, and then I'm going to tell you when we participate at the same time together. Let's pray.
Dear Father in heaven, we thank you for this sacrifice that your son was willing to make. We thank you for being willing to save us from ourselves. This emblem, the bread signifying the body of Christ being broken for us. We ask that you bless this bread, bless this sacrifice, and bless our time together. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Heavenly Father, Lord, we come before you as we remember what you've done for us, seeing our need for you. Lord, we want to pray for this grape juice, which represents your blood, Lord, that you shed freely for our sins, Lord. That one day, when you return, we can be with you. Lord, this is our prayer in Jesus' name.
Amen. Take one of these and wipe your hands. The Bible said that Jesus took bread and broke it. I don't usually touch the bread. It's broken already. So you don't. And then when he gave it to his disciples, and he said, you know, this and the wine, this is my body, this is my blood. And I'm doing this for humanity. I'm doing this for your sin. I'm going to say something else at the end as we make the appeal. I'm going to ask the congregation to stand up to participate, everybody. And then I'm going to ask the servants of the Lord that are going to distribute the emblems to come and get ready for that. As I said, as you received your portion, you sit down, and then from here, we are going to participate together. I'm going to instruct when we do it. Trying to wash our hands to keep you healthy.
Thank you.
If there is someone that seems like we are good. Let's take part in memory of Jesus. Before I finish with my conclusion, my closing remarks, during communion, we usually collected brotherhood funds, and somebody's going to be at the entrance doing that. As I meditate in those events, I know that Jesus is coming soon. And I want to see him. Not just to thank him for dying for me, but for everything he is doing with me and for me in the process of getting me ready to see him. But it's not like he just died and he just went out and said, you know, now you do what you want. He's not like that. He keeps working in our lives. He keeps watching over us. He keeps protecting us. He sends the Holy Spirit to keep teaching us, comforting us, forgiving us, restoring us. Oh, he is coming soon, and I want to see him. I want to see him, and because I'm eternally grateful for the great things he has done for me, for us. Can we stand up? We are going to have the closing song. Please, come. And then as we have that song, as we sing, if you feel like coming to the platform, just asking God to help you so you can stay put, stay firm in his grace until the second coming. Because even though we go through difficulties, I want you to be like him. Don't make those things that big, because what awaits for you is way bigger. Jesus is coming soon. And all this suffering, all these sufferings that we are going through are going to be over soon. Can we please sing?
Sorry.
When somebody does something good for you, I don't know how many of you are forgetful of things like that. I can forget when somebody mistreats me. Well, it's not like I forget, I don't hold grudge. But when somebody has been kind to me,
amen,
I will remember that to the end of my life. If somebody did something to me that that person was not supposed to do and treated me in ways that that person was not obligated to treat me in that way, I will always remember those people in my life. Now, I have a Jesus, a God, that he did not only die for me, Through our lives, he has been there for us.
Amen.
And I want to see him. I want to see his face. It's why I'm committed, God willing, to pray, to study the Bible, to meditate, to talk about him, to proclaim his name, to tell other people, because I don't want to forget what he has done for me. And when some people come with something trying to make me doubt about his love, I want to go back to the Bible and to my prayer so I can see God again in the way he is, so I can keep showing to people how loving and how good he is. And then soon he is going to come and we are going to see him and we are going to celebrate and we are going to eat. Oh, we are going to eat. Remember, this is just a symbol. The Passover supper was a real one. There was food at the table. Now imagine sitting at a table with people from every tribe, nation, country, language, every type of food and taste, and Jesus is there with us, eating with us, and we laugh together, and we eat together, and we talk together, and we ask people, tell me about your life, about your country, about your time. Abraham, can you tell me about that thing of God calling you at the age of 75 and telling you that you are going to be a daddy? I want to hear about that. Oh yes, I want to be there. I want to sit by that, around that table. And my brothers and sisters, this life is short.
Amen.
No matter how good you are doing, it's short. And if we get attached to things, we are going to end up very, very disappointed. It's why I want you to picture it, to imagine it, to ambition it, to dream it. Eternity is our thing. We are bound for eternal life. We are going to see the King. He is coming soon, and we are going to get ready to see Him. I don't know if there is someone here that has been struggling with something lately that only God knows. And sometimes you feel that you're not going to make it because the burden is too heavy. Jesus understands. He went through all of that, but he was seeing, he was projecting himself to a bright future with his children. If you are going through that, I'm going to ask you to put that in the hands of God this morning and ask God to give you a vision of eternity, of the plans he has for you. Would you like to come forward and leave whatever is that is burdening you, that is pushing you down? Do you want to drop that at the feet of Jesus today, this morning? If you want to do that, and if you want to come to the altar, just do it. But the other appeal is for us, everybody, let's commit today to get ready to meet the King soon. Would you like to do that with me? Let's pray together. Father, thank you for loving us. We are here and we know that we don't deserve your love, but we are very glad that you died for us and that you are trying to take us to be with you forever. Please stay with us, touch our hearts, heal our wounds, connect our families, protect our children, bless your church, prepare us to meet you soon. In your name, Jesus, we pray. Amen. Amen. Beautiful people, thank you for coming. Thank you for being here. You are special people. You are people of God. Next Sabbath, we are going to be worshiping the Lord again, and I hope you show up so you can be in the presence of the Lord and keep being blessed by his presence. Amen. God bless you. You can sit now.